Okay, so what we've got here is a miniature little wood carver. He's out of a 2-inch by 1-inch wide block of basswood. Just a bandsaw blank here, little pattern that I created. I'll use a red pencil, that way it's a little bit easier to see, but here'll be the bottom of his hat. We'll go ahead and mark both sides of this. Beard area. This is hand area, bottom of his jacket, bottom of his shoes. Let's get a rough idea here. So this hand over here will actually be, here's his elbow, will be in his pocket. So it'll be something like that. And then this one, he'll have his hand and be holding a carving knife. So something like this. So go ahead and mark the center of the block where the face goes. And we're gonna try to carve this in one video. If we don't make it in one video, we'll do it. It'll only take two to do it. So all I'm gonna do is gonna start by cutting the bottom part of this hat. You can use a V-tool here if it's easier for you, but we'll just do everything with the knife. And what we'll want is we'll want to bring that face to a point. We'll be rounding it from this side this way and this side that way. So you can go ahead and do that if you want to. We'll work all the way around this thing. You cut here for the back of the hat and the shoulders meet. Getting that face shaped. And you'll have a beard. So kind of got it, started getting it to shape there. What we'll do is this has got to come down some because this is where the shoulders meet. But it'll give you a good start. And so since his hand is right here, we can go ahead and take out most of this. Just start, always just do a little bit at a time up towards the body until we get it close enough, then we can figure out where we're gonna go with it. Just kind of getting rid of that. I want to leave that square for the time being, so I got enough material. Okay. Now I go ahead and we've got him standing on a a little base, so go ahead and cut his shoes. And what I'll do is I'll figure out that there's this bottom of his pant leg. I'll go ahead and make that cut there. Let's go back and forth and nothing wrong with it. If you want to work on one thing till you're completely done with it, that's fine. Back and forth on this thing. It'll be all over it. There's the middle of it. Close to the middle. Make a series of V cuts there. So we're kind of getting the shoes outline. Not a whole lot of detail with this guy, but it's a pretty good little project when it's all said and done. So now we got that. There's the bottom of his hand. We can go ahead and cut his elbow in because we know where that is. Cut his legs in there too because he's got to be round. So basically, his arms, the back of his arms, are like right there. So I'll make that cut. Do the same thing over here on this side. Now we know that his arm is going to be right there. So basically, I'm going to make a, I'm going to cut out this area right here. And then of course, we'll have his, be his pocket right there. So all I want to do is want to come in straight down, straight in on that one, and then cut back up. Take that out, and then we'll flatten all this down. Take some more out of there. So you can see it kind of starting to take shape, and we'll get all this shaped up, make it look right. Go ahead and put his hand in there. Take this out, little triangle piece right here. So it shows the separation. Then we come in here and give him a little crease there. I know we're going a little fast, but you get the idea of what we're doing. And we'll go around, and we'll probably have to bring those shoes down a little bit and kind of thin those up to find his pant legs again once we start getting him a bit closer to the shape that we want. But I like to get them established so I know that they're there. I know where I'm gonna, where I need to cut, decrease them. It's always easier to take a little bit off. But you can't put it back on. Okay, so he's starting to take a little bit of shape there. Clean up all the bandsaw marks. The brim of this hat is very thin when we get done carving it, so please pay attention to that, because it sometimes has a tendency to want to break off on you. And then we'll mark the center of his legs. I'm just going to make two cuts there, kind of show some separation, and we'll round them off. Clean all this up and give him his little back of the knee cuts there. Okay. So now that we've got that done, this is the top of his hand. He doesn't need much room there. So basically we're just gonna kind of take out this little triangle piece and in his hand, have his thumb there and take a small gouge and make a hole so we can put the little knife in there. And all I use for the knife is like a little round craft stick. It's about the perfect diameter. Then I'll just shave one part down to make it look like a tip of a knife. Obviously, we've got to round this off a little bit and bring it down a little bit, but get it to shape so it looks like a hand. So now we're gonna, here's his, where his hand stops. So I'm just gonna make my cut in there. So we can put there's where that hole will be, and we can work on that here in a little bit, but go ahead and take this face down a little bit. Still a little bit too thick. Especially right in this area right up here next to your shoulder. And pull that shoulder out a little bit. And then just show a little indication. Elbow. Now it's hard to see, but when you get this guy painted, that's when everything starts to pop out. Clean this up down here. Put the bottom of his jacket back in there. Do a little bit more once we get this hat thinned down, which I think we're about ready to do. So what I want to do, take this down some more. guy's a little hard to hold. Okay, so now I'm going to start. Rounding him off a little bit. This is the area that you need to be kind of careful with, because it will want to break off on you. And then cut back down towards this. I just got a really stubborn piece of basswood, is what I got. So you can thin this down. To get it to the shape that you want. That's a little bit better than... When I designed this pattern, I left it thick on purpose. You can get it as close as you want with, if you're cutting it out on a bandsaw. I always like to leave a little bit extra there. You come across the front and take those bandsaw marks off. Kind of open it up a little bit here. Okay, didn't look too bad. He's starting to take shape. And what I'll use, got a set of dockyard tools, and I've got, I'm not quite exactly sure what that one is, it's fairly small, but what I'll do is I'll stick it down in there in that hand, go straight down in there, and then I'll do the other side. Push it down in there pretty good. Now I'll pop that piece out. So typically what I'll do is I'll just, let me cut off a little piece of this and I'll show you. This is just like a, now this happens to be like a skewer stick. And so see, it fits down in that hole real nice. Now, obviously that's too long, but what I'll do is I'll just kind of figure out where I want like the bottom of that knife to be. And then there's my knife blade. So while I still got it on the stick there, just makes it easier. And then I'll mark that other side so I can see where I'm going here. So there's the part that's gonna be in his hand, and then there's the blade. So then I just kinda shape it. Kinda get it down to a point. That'd be perfect. Usually I paint it and kind of give it a shiny silver color. But you get the idea. Then when I get it down to the size that I want, cut it off the stick. Typically I'd use a little knife to do that, but then just glue it in his hand. I gotta do a little bit more work on that, but I'll get it to shape. Make that look a little bit more like a blade. So I guess in the next video, we will finish this guy up. So I'll have that part two. Part one and part two should be uploaded at the same time, so you guys won't have to wait another week. So stay tuned for part two.